Member Parliament, Point Fortin, Mr. Kennedy Richards Jr., Mayor of Point Fortin, Ms. Lima McCree Thomas, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It's my pleasure to have you guys here this morning to be part of our opening ceremony of our facility improvement project. It's a project that we want to undertake to bring this facility back to what we want it to be, and even bigger than that. The dream is big, so we're gonna continue to strive for the assistance, the support, whatever we can get to improve this. Point Fortin is always, to me, a forgotten city. And my job is to try to make this come back to what it is. Let's start with the opening prayer. I will let everybody stand. I will get Michael to do the opening prayer.
Pleasant good morning, each and everyone. Member of Parliament, who worship the Mayor, Councillor, special invited guests. Let us bow our head, please. Heavenly Father, as we come for you one more time, we ask you to take charge. You take charge of our operation, Lord Jesus, Father. Father, I ask you to guide and protect our leaders, oh Father. Father, guide and protect our especially invited guests, Lord Jesus, Father. Father, as we come to you once again, Father, I ask you to bless this place, Lord Father, in our new venture that we are about to take place, Lord Jesus, Father. I ask you to bless Mr. Steve David, Lord Jesus, Father. Cover him, Lord Father. Cover him, Lord Father. Cover our football fields. Cover our tennis courts, our basketball courts, our clubs, and all that we have to establish in this place, Lord Father. Father, I ask you to take the blood of Jesus and spread it all around each and every one of us right now, Father. Father, I know that we are going through a treacherous time, Lord Father. Father, we're going through a real strange time, but Father, you are the one to guide us in and out of it, Lord Jesus, Father. Father, I ask you one more time, Lord Jesus, Father, to guide and protect us, Lord Father, in Jesus' holy name.
Okay, thank you, Michael. For the people who don't know me, my name is Steve David, and this facility was leased to me to, again, what I really saw was facilities and a lot of things in Point was not going anywhere. So I thought I would try to come back and do something about it. So, as everybody know, I did live in America. I live here now. My contribution to America was a lot, and now I think my country or my community deserve more than America does, and I think that's why I'm here. The struggle is still great. It's not easy, but with the help of the mayor, with the help of the MP, and with the help of the community, we can make this happen. There is a special friend who is part of this ceremony that I first met when I came down, and she said to me, give people a reason why to come to Point. And that was the thing that triggered off my instinct to improve this facility. Because when we got it in a real dilapidated condition. Water running through this building nonstop. It was vandalized. Everything was gone. No security. Petrotrin walked out and left it with no security, and it was horrible, to say the least. But we scrambled and battled and find our way back My main guy, Michael, who did the prayer, he was one of the expatriation workers, and he did yeoman's work to get me to understand what was going on here. And, you know, and put our heads together and we start bringing people on. But we had the biggest challenge. Our biggest challenge was really COVID-19. From the time we got this facility, COVID-19 was here. So we couldn't do nothing. And we couldn't generate any kind of income to support. All we did was we had to use our personal funds to make it what it is. My employees, I have to say, I've got the best employees. I would like to introduce them, but one is in the kitchen, Allison, Lisa Sumai, my secretary, personal secretary, Michael Modest, and Chantel Matthews. And that's it. That's what we run on here. We don't have the, yes, the money. We don't have the money to really get this how we fully would like to see it, but we get some support. So myself and Lisa and Michael and my little crew, with my community involvement, there's few people in the community does get it very, very much involved. And with that, we decided we do what we have to do to bring this together. My vision is to see this facility and other facilities in Point be up and running enough to support our community that I think it's ignored, so much words, so to speak, or if not ignored, is not taken seriously. And there's a lot of things that we need to get done that is not, and I look at buildings falling apart and different things, and it's not impressive to me. And it's not impressive when I talk to my foreign counterparts or local guys about what's going on. So Lisa and I and Michael and the rest of my group, we reach out to the Prime Minister's Sports and Cultural Fund to assist us in this drive and venture. And the entire facility improvement, the entire group, the entire board of members, board members, the entire board members decided to come down and take a look. And when they did see what, they realized we do need help. And we got some help from them. So now we can kickstart this project so we can get it to where we want it to be. And it's just a start. So with their contribution and our contribution, we gonna repair the tennis courts or refurbish the tennis courts. We're gonna refurbish the basketball court, and we're gonna refence the football field. Of course, we already start getting the football field in shape. We brought down zero turn tractors and different things to make that happen. We also, well, not we also, the, you know, over the, there was a storm here not very long ago, and that did some damage to the facility as well, the fencing, the goalposts, the different things that we have to put together. So, again, nothing comes easy. I call myself Rambo. Why? Because I'm resilient. Nothing is going to stop me from making the things that I want happen. No man, I work with the guy, the bigger guy upstairs, and my passion to make this a better community with the help of the member of parliament and the mayor and anybody else that wants to join in on our bandwagon and make it happen. For all the people who have given us the support, I thank you. For my crew, meaning Michael, Lisa, Chantel, Allison, Yolandra, I thank you. I thank you guys for all the effort. We're gonna get there. We're gonna get to the finish line. I am gonna make sure I see us to the finish line. And we're gonna do whatever we have to do to make this happen. What we plan to do is incorporate many other things other than what we meet. We want to make a children's zone, a little like a park where kids can come, the families can come and spend a good day. All the people who exercise and who wants a facility to use, it's available. We want to make this something that they don't have to pay for. The money that we have to get is the money to pay our employees, not for Steve David pocket, nothing. I've put out, and I don't want to get repaid for this. This is my contribution to a city or a district that gave me everything. And that's my payback. That's going to be my payback to them. I got everything through football. And of course, I've got a company, Worldwide Safety Consultants, that we have used up some of their funds as well to make this happen. We have used mine, we have used whatever we can, but we continue to do that. So all the support we can get from the community and all the support we can get from whoever, we really appreciate it, and we will continue to strive for better things. All right? I'm not going to keep this any longer. I am going to ask our member of parliament, Mr. Kennedy Richards, to say a few words, and then I will continue. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Thing on? Thing on? Yeah, it's on. Morning, everyone. Allow me to recognize in our presence this morning the worship the mayor, Alderman Salima Thomas, Councillor Pascal, my neighbor, who is now the ambassador, or one of the ambassadors, and a winner in the Mrs. World competition that was previously held, shortly held, just in last month, Ms. Yolandra, John Edwards, the proprietor today, Mr. Steve David, all the specially invited guests, the employees, members of the media. So we're here today basically to launch a project. And this project is going to see to the refurbishment of three of the facilities here at the Clifton Hill Field of Dreams. We used to call it the club, but now it's the Field of Dreams, right? So just a bit of information into this project. This is basically a community improvement project. And so David would have spoke earlier about the fact that funds are limited, and he has a vision. But in order to have a vision, you need to have finance. So and this finance, this gap was bridged by the Office of the Prime Minister Sports and Cultural Fund on Board of Management. And I wanna just take the opportunity to recognize the Prime Minister himself, right, as well as the people who he has given the responsibility to manage this sports fund. And then I will talk to the importance of this sports fund and what this sports fund does. The chairman of that sports fund is Ms. Deborah Coyard Patton. There are a few. There's the secretary, Ms. Rosemary Richardson, Sir Devon Seal, Marla Mohammed, Ronson Hackshaw, Hazley Crawford, and Esther Ennis. And these people saw it fit to fund, or to partly fund, or however it is, that is something between them and the proprietor, this project. Because as we know, Point Fortin has always been the capital of culture and the capital of sport. And Mr. David would have said a bit before that he felt as though Point Fortin was a forgotten city. I do not hold that sentiment. However, at the time of the closing of Petrichin, and you would see around that these buildings were left unattended. And because of the lack of attention to it, it started to go downhill. If you don't take care of your body, it goes downhill, right? So this is a simple thing. So he basically came up with the proposal and he stepped in and he has this vision to re-energize this community in a way that we could recreate, you know, the atmosphere to birth the type of talent that we had before, Mr. David being one of them, you know, and there's a lot of great and exciting talent in Point that came out of Point Fortin, not just in football alone, Mr. David. This finger here was on the basketball court too. So, you know, I don't want to put myself in that field, but you know, I too utilize the opportunity on in the court, and your employee would know. We go there and we engage and the opportunity just to express yourself on the field, express yourself in a court, express yourself in sport, you know, assist you in your overall development. So this is not just fixing the court, the football field, and doing the fencing, and upgrading the basketball court, and doing the tennis court. What you are doing here today is setting the stage for the next generation of talent, you know, and for us to unearth the talent that we may not know are there. So this is indeed good, and I laud the Prime Minister and his team for ensuring that this ceremony here today is possible. You know, you spoke about the facilities, and you know, I just want to let you know that, you know, as a member of Parliament, I don't take it lightly that the facilities are not in the condition that they should be. So being my astute self, and I would have taken the opportunity to engage with the owners of all the lands here, and you may or may not know, in a very short time, in a couple months, we would have a plan going forward for the entire Clifton Hill. I met it this way when I came here in the office in 2010, but I'm not going to leave it this way, so that it's just there and it rots on it. So we are working on the upgrade, right? That is not directly onto me, but what the process has started, and in short order we would have the facilities, you know, being upgraded or being managed in a way that is not an eyesore to the people at Point Fortin and to the entire country. You spoke about money as well. Money is something that is necessary. You know, a vision alone cannot drive prosperity. A vision alone cannot just drive where you want to go. You need to have the finance and the ability. And this is a good step, Sir David, in reaching that ultimate goal. You know, this is success is a journey. It's not a destination. And we know that the pandemic has had a negative effect on the economy, a negative effect on sports. You know, but as we see the rollout now of sport in tranches, we could definitely see your vision unfold, and I hope to see your vision unfold in the near future. I would work very closely with you to ensure that what it is you're giving to the people at Point Fortin is for two things. It's what they want and what you want to see they get as well. And it may sound as the same thing, but it's not the same thing. You know, so we just need to work closely together and to ensure that that type of capital injection that you may need, that you may not have at this point in time, is given. Because there are many ways and means we could get funding to ensure that not just this facility, which is the club, but all the facilities and the programs that you want to run are off the gate. Right? Sports in general, something again you spoke about the facilities. As you all know, Mahaika Oval is nearing completion within a month or two, maybe 3 months. It shouldn't be more than 3 months that should be completed. And that presents a significant day for the people at Point Fortin, because it's something that we have waited so long for, and it's finally on the cusp of completion. Now, what the Field of Dreams is going to do, right, and what I would like to see it do, is provide that feeder for the Mahaika. If the Mahaika Oval is going to be where the professionals play, the Field of Dreams should be where you train them to be professional so that they can enter in the big league. They kind of run in the gate in the big league and play in the big league. So you must be nurtured somewhere. I think this is a very good starting point for the nurturing of young athletes in Point Fortin. You know, and football, sports, culture of Point Fortin is sports. Spoke about Coronation Park. Coronation Park is another place that should begin sometime during this year. I don't want to give a date on it, but we are well advanced in terms of design and whatnot. So just to finalize, and then we agree, and then we move forward once the funding has been identified for it. But it's very much on the front burner. So when we have all those facilities, and then the corporation will treat with the other feeder facilities like Fanny Village and Captiville, and so we would be at a point in our borough. I say borough because most of those facilities fall within the borough. Within our borough, within this constituency, to actually reach to the point where every national team in Trinidad, whether it's hockey, we have somebody represented here for Point Fortin. And it's very important, because we live in an age where sport is now on your finger, everybody in the video games, people are not really coming outside. The last 2 years they couldn't run, they couldn't do this, they couldn't do that. So it's even more important that we pay close attention and provide not just the facilities, but provide the arena and provide the games for them to come out and take part in. And before I close, I would just like to say this is a momentous occasion. I wanted to say thanks for the opportunity to be here. Miss Lisa, who would have liaised with me very, very closely, Miss Deborah Patton, who would have also called and ensured that, you know, I had to be here today, you know, that kind of thing. And Steve, for not giving up, because it's easy to be here and have a facility, and the facility is mainly sports. And then along came coronavirus, and then they shut down. The beauty queen and myself would know about that, because we went through that for a couple of months as well. You know, it's not easy to have a vision, and the reason why you can't continue to vision is because somebody has said, hey, putting a pause on you. And it showed great result to reach to this point today, where we could reopen and re-energize and reinvigorate the community via sport. I'm gonna pledge my support to the vision that you have. And I would work closely, and it's also my understanding that through the fund, the community also has to play a role, a significant role in terms of being a part of what is taking place. You know, so continue. Continue the road has just started, as I could say, because you know we now getting the road out of the sport, and I want to be a part of it. As soon as the finger heals, I back on the court again. You know, so to everyone here, let's just ensure that, you know, when times get tough, we're able to hold on to the proprietor, Mr. David, and give him a word of encouragement. It's not going to be easy, and sports is a lot more expensive than we think.
So the funds he has to stop. He needs to ask the student if they need it more.
Right, so that we can actually finish the goal so that our children could be able to have a home where they could dream. Thank you.
The Honorable Kennedy Richards Jr., Member of Parliament for Point Fortin, Founder and Director of Field of Dreams Complex, Mr. Steve David, Councillor Leslie Pascal, our Chairman of Sports, Mrs. World Ambassador, Mrs. Yolanda John Edwards, members of the committee, and also specially invited guests, Burgesses, online viewers, a special good morning. Firstly, I want to express my gratitude to the organizers for this invitation, as it's a distinct pleasure to address you all here this morning. Some of you will know and understand my enthusiasm for sports, particularly football, because of my family's participation in the game. This morning, I'm honored to be in the presence of Mr. Steve David, one of our country's football legends. In my years as a child and now as an adult, I learned of Point Fortin's great sporting history from Mr. Steve David himself and many others. Further, I see the Field of Dreams refurbishment project as another opportunity to add to the pages of Point Fortin's already amazing and rich sporting heritage. This club facility, formerly known as the Petrichan Sports Club, was renamed the Field of Dreams Sports Complex and Sports Club almost 2 years ago at the launch ceremony. Field of Dreams founder, Mr. David, highlighted his wish to give back to the Point Fortin community, as well as rekindle and revitalize enthusiasm for sports and the camaraderie it is known for. His desire is what has brought us here today in yet another phase of his vision for Point Fortin. I'm willing to wager that history is about to repeat itself with this project. To elaborate, Mr. Steve David is regarded as one of the country's most illustrious football figures. I feel compelled to point out that Neville Watty Douglas, my grandfather, and Mr. Rawlins Cox Batiste were his sporting predecessors, as they too made their mark in football. There is a saying by sporting star Willie Rodriguez, who was both a national footballer and cricketer. He said, "Once you are from Point Fortin, you could play football." And I repeat it again. Once you are from Point Fortin, you can play football. To go on, Mr. David shared the stage with other local sporting greats such as Warren Lager Archibald, Leroy Dilly DeLeon, Wilfred Bong to Score Cave, the Douglas brothers, Monty Toot Douglas, deceased, and Anthony Crapo Douglas, Leo Twinkletoes Brewster, and none other than Dick, Little Dick Fulham. And it will be remiss of me not to call my father's name, but Keith Douglas, also known as Mohammed Salim. Imagine at one time in our nation's history, there were 7 players on the national football team, all from Point Fortin, and I have just named them all. When it came to notary, the Shell Oil Company left a legacy and gifted our community with institutions for change and development. According to Ellis Lewis' book, Point Fortin, the Shell Company, a Trinidadian village. Sporting clubs and fans were hesitant to visit our small village because it was considered a rural town too far to venture. However, Shell, due to its local presence, was literally a game changer. that made an inedible contribution, sorry, to the expansion of sports. Point Fortin was formerly renowned as one of the country's finest sporting towns due to the installation of different athletic and leisure facilities. I must put in a plug here and encourage each of you who have not yet read Lewis's book to do so. Hence, this refurbishment project of Clifton Hills football field, tennis, and basketball courts, in my opinion, is about looking forward from our rich historical sporting heritage to emphasize Point Fortin's legacy and what our sporting figures have given to this country and the rest of the world. Another must-read publication is the Shell Trinidad Through the Years 1913 to 2013 by Nasser Khan. Mr. Khan highlighted that Point Fortin, as it developed, became known as one of the premier sporting towns in the country. This fact concurs with Ellis Lewis' writings, which said, great progress was made in other sporting disciplines as well, apart from football, following decades of participation and national competition. Khan further stated, the Shell Sports Club of Point Fortin inaugurated as UBAA, United British Athletic Association, in the 1930s was a force to be reckoned with a number of sports, especially football, but also cricket, tennis, basketball, netball, golf, swimming, and athletics. He added, it was the creation of the Mahaika Oval by UBOT Shell in 1936 that afforded players to hone their skills in football and cricket at the most modern facilities in the country at the time. As a result, I believe Field of Dreams and its dream team have positioned themselves to do something comparable to what Shell achieved for our town. To reiterate, history does not tend to repeat itself. It is my hope that this trajectory continues both locally and nationally. The Mahaika Oval's reconstruction, which is nearing completion, and our Member of Parliament would have so shared with us the almost completion time, which is not too far away, is the birthplace to many of the country's greatest footballers as well as other sportsmen and women. I'm sure the Oval brings back memories for many of us. I'm sure it does, Mr. Steve David, for you. Including Mr. David's sports contemporaries who are thankfully still alive. Thank you, Mr. Steve David. Kennedy Richards Jr., the Member of Parliament for Point Fortin, is aware of the surrounding issues of our local sporting community. Mid last year, the Honorable Member of Parliament joined me for a sports forum where sporting representatives were asked to discuss and share difficulties they encounter. Athletics, football, tennis, and archery were among the sporting disciplines represented. Our sporting facilities, which included Mahaika Oval and the Coronation Park, were in the forefront of our talks. Mr. David, I can't help but think that the name Field of Dreams may have been premised on the movie of the same name, and if so, I am sure my father, Salim Keith Douglas, and my uncle, Monty, whose names are both etched in our football sporting archives, must be with us right now in spirit, calling out to you, A. Smell, score this goal for the boys now. Mr. David, I can't help but believe in your brand. Sorry. The pandemic did not hinder this initiative to revitalize unused, abandoned, and underutilized areas so that they may be restored into places where anyone can improve their skills and talent, exercise, and live healthy lifestyles. in positioning our community to welcome new and rising stars. I look forward to seeing the unveiling of the refurbished facility when it is completed. As I close, I must add that the Point Fortin Borough Corporation is prominent of creating sustainable, innovative, and vibrant community spaces that represent the dedication of individuals who want to have a good social impact on our community. So as to ensure Point Fortin is the preferred place to live, work, invest, and most importantly, recreate. Keep up the great work, Mr. Steve David, and the committee members of the Field of Dreams Sporting Complex. I thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. Thank you, Ms. McCray. Ms. McCray Thomas. As you guys know, I was all into football, but remember, I am doing the facility of tennis and basketball. Haven't touched football yet, so I'm going down that road right now. But it's also sports and culture. So we do have some dance classes coming up next week or the week after that. We do have some pan. We do have some other cultural stuff as well. But we want to continue down the same roads, sports and culture. We also have in our staff, so to speak, occasionally, whenever she's available, Miss World Ambassador, Miss Yolanda John, who assists us. She came in a little bit late, so we didn't have time to introduce her in an official manner, but we welcome you and glad to have you here. And last but not least, we have Field of Dreams Football Academy that we start here, and we want to start next week. It's under 14 we start with, and you're going to hear big things about that little group that I'm starting with. The mayor's son would be a member, I hope. And as she mentioned, we had seven guys on the national team at the same time. She forgets Sydney Augustine, which is 8, and one other, so it was nearly 9. So we have to duplicate that, and hopefully we will. Okay, in closing, if anybody have any questions, I will answer them. If not, we will bring Ms. Lisa Sumai for a vote of thanks. Any questions for anybody? You would do what?
I would like to give a response from the community, your neighbors.
Oh, you would?
Please.
Okay, so let me invite you up as a community member to say a few words.
Good day, ladies and gentlemen. And I must say to the entire team, the esteemed team, one of the things, my name is Rena Douglas. I am from the community of Clifton Hill, Point Fortin. And one of the things that resonated with me, and I had to really come and say thank you to Mr. David, to our esteemed panel. It has been something I have been waiting for quite some time, and I represent the sentiments of the people of Point Fortin. One of the things that really resonated is, from a sport perspective, starting over. How many times we had to start over, and Point Fortin is no different. One person said to me, Point Fortin dry up, but I'm saying to us today, starting over, we are springing up to rise again, looking straight ahead at the finish line. And Mr. Steve David and all of the rest who have spoken before me, they speak of commitment. of love. You know, I'm his neighbor, and even through the tough times during the, when the pandemic was in all its strength, he held on. He was so accommodating. And in terms of sustainable development, he's not only looking at one age group per se, he looks at the children, the young people, the women, the men, and even the seniors. So, you know, just my voice, you know, from the heart of the man, I want to say thank you on behalf of your neighbors in Clifton Hill. And you have our support. Thank you.
Good day. Good day, all. Respected Chairman, Member of Parliament for Point Fortin, Mr. Kennedy Richards Jr., Our Worship, the Mayor of Point Fortin, Ms. Lima Thomas, Councillors, Mrs. Ambassador Yolandra Drawn Edwards, specially invited guests, let me first of all start by giving glory to the Almighty God for making today's occasion a resounding success. On behalf of the founder of Field of Dreams Football Show and Field of Dreams Sports Complex and Lounge, Mr. David, Board of Directors, the Dream Team, I express our profound and most sincere gratitude to you all for honoring all our invitations. I would like to thank all our speakers for their kind words of wisdom and encouragement. To the board members of the Sport and Culture Fund, I say also a special heartfelt thank you for placing your faith in our project. The Dream Team are forever grateful and promise to make you proud. As we close our small ceremony, I say thank you to each and everyone for fitting us in your tight schedule today to be a part of the ceremony. Please join us on the tour of our project sites, and that will be followed by refreshments. Do have a safe and productive day. Thank you.
Things that's held us down, but now it looks like things are finally coming around. I know we've got a long, long way to go, and where we'll end up, I don't know. But we won't let nothing hold us back. We're putting our show together, we're polishing up our act. And if you've ever been held down before, I know refuse to be held down anymore.
Don't you let nothing, nothing stand in your way. I want you to listen, listen to every word I say, every word I say. Ain't no stopping us now.
Trying to make it, they only push you aside. They really don't have nowhere to go.